हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी आर परफॉर्मिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम। ओके, सो यू नो दैट सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम कैन बी अप्लाइड टू एनी लीनियर नेटवर्क व्हेन देयर आर मोर देन वन एनर्जी सोर्सेस। ओके, सो फॉर टुडेज एक्सपेरिमेंट आई एम कंसिडरिंग दिस सर्किट। सो एज यूजुअल वी आर टेकिंग दिस टी टाइप नेटवर्क। इफ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन टेक एनी नेटवर्क। ओके, एंड वी आर यूजिंग थ्री रजिस्टर्स बेसिकली, R1, R2 एंड R3। ओके, एंड टू पावर सप्लाय वी आर कनेक्टिंग, वोल्टेज सोर्सेस वी आर यूजिंग। सो सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम कैन बी अप्लाइड ओनली व्हेन देर आर मोर देन वन एनर्जी सोर्स। सो वी नीड एटलीस्ट टू एनर्जी सोर्सेस। ओके, एंड नाउ फॉर दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी आर यूजिंग दिस एक्सपेरिमेंटल सेटअप। ओके, सो ऑलरेडी वी हैव यूज दिस सेटअप फॉर थेवेनिन्स एंड नॉर्टन्स थ्योरम। ओके, सो सेम सेटअप वी कैन यूज फॉर सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम। सो हियर यू कैन फाइंड देर आर थ्री रेजिस्टेंसेस, R1, R2 एंड R3। ओके, एंड फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू एवरी रेजिस्टेंस वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड दिस कनेक्शंस फॉर एमिटर। सो I1, I2 एंड I3 विल कैन बी यूज फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू R1, R2 एंड R3 रिस्पेक्टिवली। एंड फ्रॉम दिस टू साइड्स वी कैन कनेक्ट टू डिफरेंट वोल्टेज सोर्सेस। ओके, एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी मेजर्ड दिस वैल्यूज बाय यूजिंग ओहम मीटर। ओके, and from the back side you can see that we have already connected, soldered all the resistances. Okay, so this is about your experimental setup. Okay, this is a handmade kit. Okay, and again what we have to do in this experiment, we are basically calculating the current flowing through R2, this middle resistance. We are measuring the current flowing through this resistance. So now your R2 is acting as a load, so therefore current flowing through this is we are calling this current as IL, load current. So these are the values of R1, R2 and R3. Okay, and so far as procedure is concerned, what we are doing, initially you know that while applying superposition theorem, what you have to do, you have to activate one source at a time. So first of all we will activate 5 volt. Okay, and that time we will disable 1 volt and we will measure this current. Okay, as you can see over here, only 5 volt is active. So at that time V2 is disabled. Okay, and the next time what we are doing, we are enabling only 1 volt and we will disable 5 volt. So you can see that 5 volt is shorted. Okay, and so far as readings are concerned, basically we have divided the observation table into two parts. So IL dash is the current flowing when only 5 volt is active. So you can see over here IL dash. Okay, IL double dash is the current flowing when only 1 volt is active. Okay, and finally we are adding these two currents, IL dash and IL double dash. So we will get IL. Okay, so this is about observation. Okay, and later on what we will do the actual calculations. Okay, and whatever values we are getting, we will write those values over here. And what should happen? Your observed values should match with calculated values. So if your values are matching, then we can say that our superposition theorem is verified. Okay, so let us start the experiment. So we are doing the connections as per this circuit diagram. So already some connections are done on this board. What you have to do, only you have to connect external power supply V1 and V2. Okay, and here there is provision for 3 ammeters. Okay, but we want to measure current flowing only through R2, middle resistance. Okay, so we will not use this I1 and I3 ammeter. So when any ammeter is not used, it should be shorted. Okay, so we will short these two ammeters. Okay, and again one thing is remaining. For providing power supply to this circuit, we are using this dual regulated power supply, DC power supply. Okay, and what is our V1? 5 volt. And what is V2? 1 volt. So I have already set this voltage to 5 volt and 1 volt. Okay, so if there is any fluctuation, you can set the desired voltage, okay, by using these knobs. Okay, now we will do the actual connections. So first of all, while doing connections, your power supply should be off. Okay, so what I will do, positive of the 5 volt I will connect at this point. Okay, negative of 5 volt I will connect at this point. Okay, now I want to measure current flowing through this. So this and this ammeter is not required, so I will connect a short circuit over here. Okay, so I will short these two terminals. Again here I will short these two terminals. Okay, so I1 and I3 we are not using, we want to measure current flowing through this middle resistance. Okay, and similarly what we will do, we will connect 1 volt from this side. Okay, and now what is remaining, only you have to connect ammeter over here. Okay, so what you should do, you should use an ammeter. So I am using this multimeter as an ammeter. So here you can see that we have selected DC range. By using this knob you can change AC to AC or DC. Since we have connected DC power supply, we are using DC, and you can see that I have selected milliampere range over here. Okay, and again one thing you have to remember, you have to connect the red wire in milliampere and black wire should always be connected to the common. Okay, if you want to use this as an ammeter. Okay, so now what I will do, I will connect the positive op ammeter over here, okay, at this point, and negative to the ground line. Okay, so now your ammeter is set up. Okay, so your experimental setup is now ready, and what you have to do, you have to just turn on the power supply and you have to take the readings. Okay, so now we have connected both power supply. Okay, so whatever current we are getting through this is nothing but what, your IL, means your final current, because now both of your circuit sources are active. So I will turn on the power supply. So you have to turn on the power supply. As soon as you turn on the power supply, what happens, you will get some value of current on this ammeter. So what you are getting, 1.31 milliampere. So this is nothing but your total load current. Okay, current flowing through this resistance R2. Note down this value. So we have noted this value, 1.31 milliampere we are getting total current. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to find IL dash and IL double dash. Now you know that while applying superposition theorem, at a time you have to activate only one source. So now what we are doing in first step, we are keeping only 5 volt active. So what you have to do, you have to disable this voltage. So for that purpose, what we are doing, we are replacing that voltage, second voltage, with its internal resistance. Okay, so in simply you can remember that if you are having voltage source, you have to short the voltage. If you are having current source, you have to open the current source. So now what I will do, I will short this voltage. So first of all, turn off this power supply, and you want to short 1 volt. So this is your 1 volt, second channel is your 1 volt. So simply what I will do, I will short these two terminals. So if these two terminals are shorted, if these two terminals are shorted, it means your 1 volt is disabled. Okay, and now again I will turn on the power supply. So now we are getting some value of current, 1.19 milliampere. So this is nothing but your IL dash. So here you can see that when only 5 volt is active, your current is IL dash. So we will write this current over here, and next time we will short this 5 volt and we will activate 1 volt. At that time IL double dash will flow. That value we will note down over here. Okay, so what current you are getting, 1.19 milliampere. We will note down this value. So now we have noted this value. Now what we will do, again we will turn off the power supply. Now you have to go for step 2. So in step 2 what you are doing, so here only 5 volt was active. Now we will keep only 1 volt active and we will disable 5 volt, means we have to short 5 volt. Okay, so for that purpose what I will do, I will turn off the power supply. Now I will short 5 volt like this. Okay, so 5 volt terminals are shorted like this. Okay, and now I will activate 1 volt. Okay, so positive I will connect and negative I will connect over here. Okay, so now only 1 volt is active. Okay, 5 volt is disabled. So again turn on the power supply, 0.11 milliampere, 0.11 milliampere. Note down this value. So as you can see, we have noted this value, 0.11 milliampere. Okay, now you can check whether your experiment is correct or not from this. So you know that IL dash and IL double dash both are flowing through R2. So if you add these two currents, you should get IL. Means what is the formula of IL? IL dash plus IL double dash. Superposition theorem states that current flowing through load resistance is algebraic sum of current flowing due to individual sources. So IL dash is flowing due to 5 volt. Okay, and IL double dash is flowing due to 1 volt. So if we do the algebraic addition of these two, so we are getting almost 1.30 milliampere. And what was your observed value? 1.31 milliampere. So same value, almost same value we are getting. So this indicates that our experiment is correct. Okay, Now this is about demonstration part. Now later on we are doing the calculations and we will observe the calculated values, and you will observe that those values are approximately matching with your observed values. Okay, so this is about demonstration part. So friends, we have already seen the demonstration part and we have got the results for current flowing through this R2. Okay, so experimentally our value was 1.31 milliampere. Okay, now we will verify the same experiment theoretically. Okay, so as per the procedure, what we have to do, first we have to apply. So friends, now we will see the procedure for this Thevenin's theorem. Okay, now as per the procedure, you have to apply one voltage at a time. Okay, so first of all we will activate 5 volt and we will disable 1 volt. So the equivalent diagram will be like this. Here you can see that I have applied only 5 volt. Okay, and here I have shorted 1 volt. Okay, so 1 volt is disabled, only 5 volt is active. So now what happens? Due to this 5 volt, some current flows. Okay, at this point that current will get divided into R2 and R3. So we have to measure this IL dash. Okay, so suppose IT is the total current flowing from this supply, and this IT comes at this point, it will get divided into two parts. So we can use current divider over here. So by current divider rule, what you are getting? Current flowing through R2 we have to find out. That is nothing but what? IL dash. So we are measuring current through R2. So we will leave R2, we will consider R3. So according to current divider, you have to take another resistance. So R3 upon addition of resistances in both paths. Okay, so R2 plus R3, and this should be multiplied by total current. So suppose IT is the total current flowing. Okay, so now we already know the values of R1, R2 and R3. Put these values. Okay, IT is unknown. So we first of all we have to calculate what is the value of IT. So what you are getting, IT is nothing but total current. So what do you mean by total current? Total current is total voltage divided by total resistance of the circuit. Okay, so here what is your total voltage? 5 volt you are applying. Okay, and what is your total resistance? So here you can see that R1 is in series with parallel combination of R2 and R3. So R2 parallel to R3. Okay, so this is your total resistance. So if you put the values of R1, R2 and R3, you will get total current. So we have written values of R1, R2 and R3. Now calculate this value. So when we do the calculations, we are getting total current as 2.48 milliampere. Okay, so this is your total current. Now put this value in the above equation. Okay, so you will get the value of IL dash. So what is your IL dash then? So here we have written all the values of R1, R2, R2 and R3 and total current. Okay, so calculate this. So here we are getting 1.18 milliampere. So this is your current flowing through the load resistance due to 5 volt only. So this is your first answer. Okay, so what you are getting, IL dash 1.18 milliampere. So this we will write in the calculated values. Okay, now similarly we will calculate IL double dash. So for that purpose we have to activate 1 volt and we have to disable 5 volt. So friends, here you can see we have disabled 5 volt source. Okay, we have only enabled 1 volt source. Okay, now due to this 1 volt, whatever current flowing through this R2, we are calling this as IL double dash. Okay, so first of all we have to find out the current flowing through this R3. So that is nothing but your total current. Okay, so when this total current comes at this node, some current will pass through this R2, some current will pass through this R1, means current will get divided. So we can use current divider rule over here. So by current divider rule, now what we can write? IL double dash. So IL double dash is flowing through R2. So we have to take opposite resistance. So R1 upon total resistance, R1 plus R2, and multiply with total current. Okay, now total current is unknown. So first we will calculate total current. What is total current? Total voltage upon
total resistance. Okay, so what is your total voltage? 1 volt you are applying here. Okay, and what is total resistance you are getting? R1 and R2 are in parallel. Okay, so R1 parallel to R2. Okay, and these two, combination of these two is in series with R3. So plus R3. Okay, so now put the values. So put these values and calculate the answer. So now calculate this value, what you are getting? 374 microampere. So this is your total current. Put this value in this equation. Okay, here put the value of IT, R1 and R2, you will get IL double dash. So we have written all the values. Now calculate this, you will get 0.116 milliampere. So this is nothing but your IL double dash. Write this value over here, 0.116 milliampere. So this is your IL double dash. Now what is remaining? IL. So calculate IL. So our step 3 is nothing but calculation of IL. Okay, so what you are getting by superposition theorem, what you are getting, your IL is nothing but what? IL dash plus IL double dash, because according to superposition theorem, your total current is algebraic sum of currents due to individual sources. So IL dash is due to 5 volt, IL double dash is due to 1 volt. So if we do the algebraic addition, we will get IL. So what you are getting here, 1.19 milliampere we have got. Okay, plus this is what, 0.116 milliampere. Okay, so do the addition. So friends, here your IL comes out to be 1.306 milliampere. Okay, so this is your final current according to superposition theorem. Okay, now we will note down this value in above table. So what you are getting, 1.306 milliampere. Okay, so we have got all the values, IL dash, IL double dash and IL. So if you compare these values with your experimental results, so here IL dash was 1.19, here it is 1.18 milliampere, so almost same value. Here it was 0.11, here now it is 0.116, so again almost same value. And here your total current was 1.31 milliampere, here it is almost similar, 1.306 milliampere. So in this way we can verify that we are getting same value during observation and during calculations. So this verifies our superposition theorem. So by using this experimental process, you can verify the superposition theorem. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this video. If you are having any doubts and difficulties, please let me know in the comment box. Okay, and please do not forget to subscribe this channel. So thank you very much and have a nice day. Thank you.